वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस विद यू अबाउट द कंसेप्ट ऑफ प्लीडिंग्स एज कंटेम्पलेटेड अंडर द कोड ऑफ सिविल प्रोसीजर. Order 6 Rule 1 defines pleadings as plaint or written statement, and Rule 2 lays down the fundamental principles of pleadings. Rules 3 to 13 requires the parties to supply necessary particulars. Rule 14 and 15 provides for signing and verification of pleadings. Rule 16 empowers the court to strike out unnecessary pleadings. And Rule 17 and 18 contains provisions relating to amendment of pleadings. Rule 1. Rule 1 defines pleadings as plaint or written statement. As per the definition given by Mr. Moga in his book on Law of Pleadings, 1983, page number 1, wherein he defined pleadings as the statements in writing drawn up and filed by each party to a case, stating what his contentions will be at the trial and give all such details as his opponent needs to know in order to prepare his case in answer thereof. Now I would like to come up to the object of pleadings. The object of pleadings is to bring parties to definite issues and to diminish expense and delay and to prevent surprise at the time of hearing. And the leading case on this is that of Throp versus Holdsworth, wherein Lord Jessel MR stated that the whole object of pleadings is to bring parties to an issue, and the meaning of the rules was to prevent the issue being enlarged, which would prevent either party from knowing when the cause came on for trial, what the real points to be discussed and decided was. In another case, the Supreme Court, in the case of Ganesh Trading Company versus Moji Ram, has held that the provisions relating to pleadings in civil cases are meant to give each side intimation of the case of the other so that it may be met to enable the courts to determine what is really at issue between the parties and to prevent deviations from the course which litigation on particular cause of action must take. Further, in Virender versus Vinayak, 1999, one SSA, wherein Supreme Court has held that the object behind pleadings are twofold. Number one, that is to afford the other side intimation regarding particular facts of his case so that they may be met by other side. Second, to enable the court to determine what is really the issue between the parties. So these are the prime considerations or the object behind pleadings. Next, what are the rules of pleadings? or the fundamental rules of pleadings. The fundamental rules of pleadings are: pleading should state facts, not law. The facts should state material facts only, and not the evidentiary facts. Pleading should not state the evidence. The facts should be stated in a concise form. So these are the fundamental rules of pleadings, which are mentioned under Order 6, Rule 2, CPC. Now we will straight away come to the other relevant portion, which a law student must know, that is the concept of amendment of pleadings. Amendment of pleadings, the main object behind the amendment of pleading is to determine the real issue in controversy between the parties, provided it did not cause injustice or prejudice to the other side, meaning thereby to promote the ends of justice and not for defeating them. The leading case on amendment of pleading is Cropper versus Smith, wherein it was held that the object of the court is to decide the rights of the parties and not to punish them for their mistakes they make in the conduct of their cases by deciding otherwise than in accordance with their rights. I know of no kind of error or mistake which, if not fraudulent or intended to overreach, the court ought not correct if it can be done without injustice to the other party. Now, on which particular conditions or which particular grounds the leave to amend can be granted by the court to the party? The first is to determine the real question in controversy. Second, it can be allowed without injustice to the other side. Thirdly, it must not prejudice the other side. And the error or the mistake, which if fraudulent, should not be made a ground for rejecting the application for amendment of pleading. So these are the grounds to be kept in mind while allowing or rejecting a amendment application. Now, at any stage of the proceeding, leave to amend may be granted at any stage of the proceeding. This is the position before 2002, that is the 2002 Amendment Act of CPC. But after the insertion of proviso by 2002 amendment under Order 6, Rule 17 CPC, which restricts the power of the court and declares that the court shall not allow such an amendment after the commencement of trial, unless it comes to the conclusion that in spite of due diligence, the matter could not have been raised by the party before the commencement of trial. Now, what would be the effect of amendment? The effect of the amendment is that it relates back to the date of the suit as originally filed. So it has been given a retrospective effect instead of prospective effect. Next question is, what will be the consequence if the plaintiff fails to amend the plaint within the stipulated time as given by the court? If a party who has obtained an order for leave to amend does not amend within the time specified, or if no time is specified within 14 days of the order, then he shall not be permitted to amend after the expiry of the specified time, unless the said time is further extended by the court itself. So it cannot be allowed unless and until the same would be allowed by the court later on. And this would be done by the court only on the sufficient grounds shown by the party to the case. And if sufficient grounds are not shown, then the same would not be allowed later on. So this is all about today's lecture. Hope you have learned a lot from it. We'll meet you in my next lecture, and the topic of my next lecture would be on plaint, which is given under Order 7 of the CPC, wherein we will be dealing with the meaning of the plaint and its relations with the summons, and thereafter its relationship with the suit, and thereafter its interconnection with the written statement. So till then, stay home, Stay safe and be positive. Hope you have a good day ahead. Thank you very much. Will meet you in a short while. Thanks once again.